Janet Greenland is the telephone BDM at Royal London Equity Release. And Janet, I believe you've got an absolute wealth of experience within this sector. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I understand you've got 8 years, specifically equity release advice experience, but then you've got some mortgage advice background from years prior to that. So it's great to have you on board, and it's great to have your expertise running through the presentation today. In terms of learning objectives for today's session, Janet's going to be running through how Royal London Equity Release's recent rebrand strengthens their proposition, what it actually means to you and the market, how their approach to flexible underwriting and their advice support sets them apart from the rest of the market, and what is the view of Royal London for the future of our market, the future of our industry, and their plans for innovation. There's been a ton of innovation over the last year to 18 months, Janet. So the bar is up here. So expect to see some great stuff for you over the session ahead. In terms of housekeeping, there will be a Q&A, an opportunity for a Q&A at the end of this session. Please do take advantage of the chat box. Throughout, I will pop some links, some comments, some items, some prompts in the chat box as well. So be sure to have that pinned and open at the side of your screen. For the benefit of you and the benefit of everybody else watching, if you can just be conscious on your microphones, we have muted everybody on entry. But if you do come off to take a question, answer a question, please do remember to mute it back as well. If you're struggling with internet and bandwidth, all those technical jargons, you can turn your cameras off, but you're welcome to have them on. We're a nice sort of small group of session this morning, so we're nice to see your faces on this Wednesday morning. I will put some links in the chat box here as well. This session is being recorded. You will get a follow-up email from AdviceWise with the link to that recording, so you can watch it back retrospectively. You can share it with your colleagues, your peers, anybody that might have missed this session. And you can also request your CPD certificates after this session as well. So no need to chase me, no need to email me asking for your CPD certificates. You can do that via the follow-up email that we will send out. I will get you on to passing you over to Janet in just a brief second. And we'll get the screen, the slides shared as well. But I just want to jump on and just mention a few stats, a few thought-provoking ideas in and around the market at the moment, because I know it's been tough over the last 12 months and probably a lot more than that actually since the mini budget. But things are starting to show a bit of a bright light ahead, and things are starting to pick up, certainly from our perspective when it comes to advisor engagement, when it comes to brokers doing product research on the platform. Numbers seem to be on a positive trend week on week, which is really strong. As we know, there is a growing demand for these over 55s later life lending solutions. The over 55 population is expected to rise by 20% in the next 10 years. There's one in three retirees have a risk and experience a pension income gap. So there is a pension shortfall, and there is always going to be a need for this type of product set. So the overruling thought of a growing market is very much there, but I appreciate it's been incredibly tough this year, the last 18 months, and it probably is going to be for the next 6 months as well. We're seeing base rate come down, although it held last time, but we have seen it come down. So we're starting to see mortgage rates, 3 and 5 year fixes, starting with a 3%. And that can be quite difficult for customers to understand and digest when they're talking lifetime mortgage rates at 5, 6, and 7%. So there is becoming to be a bit of an increasing gap between mortgage rates and later life rates. And it's obviously all to do with the funding models and the solutions there. So upskilling yourself will help you and make you better equipped to having those conversations with your clients as well. So without any more updates from myself, I'll pass you over to Janet. I'll start putting some bits in the chat box, and then we'll get on with the presentation there. So Janet, I'm going to stop sharing for a brief second. If you could share your slides, that'd be brilliant. Janet Greenland is the telephone BDM at Royal London Equity Release. And Janet, I believe you've got an absolute wealth of experience within this sector. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I understand you've got 8 years, specifically equity release advice experience, but then you've got some mortgage advice background from years prior to that. So it's great to have you on board, and it's great to have your expertise running through the presentation today. In terms of learning objectives for today's session, Janet's going to be running through how Royal London Equity Release's recent rebrand strengthens their proposition, what it actually means to you and the market, how their approach to flexible underwriting and their advice support sets them apart from the rest of the market, And what is the view of Royal London for the future of our market, the future of our industry, and their plans for innovation? There's been a ton of innovation over the last year to 18 months, Janet. So the bar is up here. So expect to see some great stuff for you over the session ahead. In terms of housekeeping, there will be a Q&A, an opportunity for a Q&A at the end of this session. Please do take advantage of the chat box. Throughout, I will pop some links, some comments, some items, some prompts in the chat box as well. So be sure to have that pinned and open at the side of your screen. For the benefit of you and the benefit of everybody else watching, if you can just be conscious on your microphones, we have muted everybody on entry. But if you do come off to take a question, answer a question, please do remember to mute it back as well. If you're struggling with internet and bandwidth, all those technical jargons, you can turn your cameras off, but you're welcome to have them on. We're a nice sort of small group of session this morning, so we're nice to see your faces on this Wednesday morning. I will put some links in the chat box here as well. This session is being recorded. You will get a follow-up email from AdviseWise with the link to that recording, so you can watch it back retrospectively. You can share it with your colleagues, your peers, anybody that might have missed this session. And you can also request your CPD certificates after this session as well. So no need to chase me, no need to email me asking for your CPD certificates. You can do that via the follow-up email that we will send out. I will get you on to passing you over to Janet in just a brief second. And we'll get the screen, the slides shared as well. But I just want to jump on and just mention a few stats, a few thought-provoking ideas in and around the market at the moment. Because I know it's been tough over the last 12 months and probably a lot more than that, actually, since the mini budget. But things are starting to show a bit of a bright light ahead, and things are starting to pick up, certainly from our perspective when it comes to advisor engagement, when it comes to brokers doing product research on the platform. Numbers seem to be on a positive trend week on week, which is really strong. As we know, there is a growing demand for these over 55s later life lending solutions. The over 55s population is expected to rise by 20% in the next 10 years. There's one in three retirees have a risk and experience a pension income gap. So there is a pension shortfall, and there is always going to be a need for this type of product set. So the overruling thought of a growing market is very much there, but I appreciate it's been incredibly tough this year, the last 18 months, and it probably is going to be for the next 6 months as well. We're seeing base rate come down, although it held last time, but we have seen it come down. So we're starting to see mortgage rates, 3 and 5 year fixes, starting with a 3%. And that can be quite difficult for customers to understand and digest when they're talking lifetime mortgage rates at 5, 6, and 7%. So there is becoming to be a bit of an increasing gap between mortgage rates and later life rates. And it's obviously all to do with the funding models and the solutions there. So upskilling yourself will help you and make you better equipped to having those conversations with your clients as well. So without any more updates from myself, I'll pass you over to Janet. I'll start putting some bits in the chat box, and then we'll get on with the presentation there. So Janet, I'm going to stop sharing for a brief second. If you could share your slides, that'd be brilliant.
Okay, so today's presentation, as Daniel said, is how innovation, property wealth and flexible solutions could support your clients through retirement. So a little bit of an agenda here. So first of all, introducing Royal London Equity Release and what our rebrand means for you. Little bit about the industry. I know Daniel's already touched on it, but we'll just talk a little bit about the industry as it is at the moment and some opportunities for 2024. Little bit about benefits of using Royal London Equity Release, bit about our underwriting approach and exceptional service, and also the future of Royal London Equity Release and our plans for innovation. And then hopefully there's some time for some questions and answers. If I just start from the beginning, Responsible Lending rebranded to Royal London Equity Release back in August 2024. So it's actually bringing our brand in line with our product range. So just for those that don't know, I'll just touch sort of from the beginning, if you like. So Responsible Lending are an equity release lender that launched in 2017. Roy London started to be an introducer for responsible lending for equity release around the 2020 mark. But Roy London wants to get into the equity release market. Rather than setting up themselves, they decided to acquire an equity release company. So by using our skill set and their brand, they acquired Roy London back in 2023. When we first came into the market, we actually came in as Responsible Lending Roy London. So a bit of a mouthful, but as I say, we've now rebranded to Roy London Equity Release. So I'll talk a little bit more about why that is really good for the equity release market. In addition to the equity release lending arm, Roy London, as I'm sure most of you will know, are the largest mutual in the UK. So that obviously adds a lot of weight and confidence into the equity release market. When you are talking to clients, you can talk about Roy London having 8.6 million life and pension policies. So again, it's just adding that confidence when you're chatting to your clients. So what does the rebrand mean for you? So first of all, we're now fully aligned with Roy London, a trusted household name, as I've just said, enabling us to bring a broader support and new innovations. So we've now got the infrastructure and the support of UK's largest mutual. And what we want to do is make it easier for brokers to write business. Having the rebrand also is a less confusing journey for clients. You know, with an established trusted brand. What we were finding when we first launched last year, it was really confusing, not only for ourselves, but for the advisors and also for your clients, because we were dual branded and there was a lot of explanation around it. There was confusion getting onto the websites, that type of thing. But now it's just a nice, strong, clear brand, Roy London Equity Release. And with our commitment to the future of the equity release industry, you can find greater confidence in a difficult market. Again, I think with Roy London coming into the market at this difficult time, again, it just adds a lot of confidence that, you know, we're coming in at this time and we're here for the long term. Roy London are here for the long term. So just want to, I don't really suppose I need to tell you much about how the market is at the moment, but just wanted to have a little bit of a snapshot of where we are. Again, Daniel's already sort of touched on this, but what this graph is showing you, just to put it into perspective where we are at the moment, this is actually from the Equity Release Council. And basically what it's showing is the decline in equity release over the last 18 or so months. We are seeing things differently at Roy London. So there's a different market at the moment. There's a little bit less aspirational and more need for equity release rather than the aspirational objectives. I don't think I really need to go through this, but I'll just very briefly highlight some of the reasons, which I'm sure we all know. But first of all, we've got the higher rates, again, as Daniel's already touched on. We've got increased options as well for clients through traditional mortgages. So, you know, mortgage lenders are being more innovative in the market and offering the clients different solutions. We've got lower loan to values. So we've seen all them higher LTVs that we were used to a couple of years ago. They've gone from the market. And again, it's more difficult to place some of your cases. We've got divided opinions about whether equity release is a good option or not a good option with the rates being where they are. And we've got consumer advice confidence in the market, not where it is. But again, when you do see good brands, strong brands coming into the market, hopefully that will add a bit more confidence. We've got advisors leaving the industry. We've got negative press. So all of these things, obviously, they're just basically showing us where we are at the moment. The equity release markers actually think that we're going to finish below 2 billion, which is a bit of a shame, but we have got confidence that it will bounce back. We've also got the larger firms reassessing. So the larger equity release firms, they're assessing their strategy for 2025 and obviously streamlining operations. So we're not seeing them big adverts on the television at the moment from the bigger equity release companies. And again, that's not raising the profile for equity release in the market as a whole. I just want to sort of remind everyone of the opportunities and why people do want to use equity release. So although the market's not been where it is for the last couple of years, the need is still there. So you've got homeowners that are reaching retirement without disposable income, required to allow them to have, a dream retirement. So the term we always hear is asset rich and cash poor. And this is then exacerbated by you've got your decline in final salary pension schemes, interest-only mortgages with no repayment vehicles, a growing untapped housing wealth, people living longer in retirement, and lack of individual pension provisions. So obviously we know all these opportunities are there, but currently clients just aren't biting at the moment because of all the reasons I've just mentioned before. So I think the important thing is to keep engaging with your clients and keep engaging with your introducers, so that when the market does come back, we're all ready to go. What I wanted to do also is just tell you a little bit about Royal London Equity Release's USPs. So what I don't want to do is really talk about our features today. I'll very briefly mention them. You know, we've got our overpayment of 10%, downsizing protection after 5 years, got the 3-year waiver for your joint applications when first party passes away or goes into care. And you've also got fixed early repayment charges with ourselves. So nothing is gilt rate linked. But apart from them features, what I wanted to do is just talk about our USPs and why it's good to use Royal London. So first of all, the USPs. So we do have something called a 21-day rate lock. I know a number of lenders out there will guarantee your rates once that you've got your KFI, but we actually go a step further. So probably the easiest way to explain this is, let's say, for example, you place a case with a lender, case gets declined for whatever reason, you come back to your sourcing system and rates have gone up. If that does happen, if you go back to your original sourcing and Royal London Equity Release were competitive, even if you've not had a KFI from us, long as nothing's changed, so long as the figures are all the same, different, you know, the lump sum, the valuation, etc., that you're looking for, long as that is all exactly the same, then we'll honour the rate that is on the your sourcing. We'll be able to produce the KFI, and long as you submit the application within the 21 days from the original sourcing, then we'll honour the rate for you. So it's always worthwhile, if you do get any declines, to always look back at your original sourcing and make sure Royal London are competitive. We'll also do rate adjustments for birthdays. So again, I know I do appreciate that a lot of the higher loan to values have gone now, but if you are looking for the maximum possible with your client and you do know that they've got a birthday coming up, if your client's got a birthday within the next 50 days, then we'll be able to produce the KFI on that next birthday, rather than you having to produce a new KFI, new addendum, etc. So just an added little bonus with ourselves. I'm not going to go through the cost. I won't demonstrate the cost of equity release estimated today, but there is one on our website. And where this is really useful, some of you may use them on various websites, but it's really useful for your clients who maybe you can't place on a normal mortgage, or maybe they are they have got an interest-only mortgage, but they do want to overpay more than the interest. Now, because we have a traditional rolled-up lifetime mortgage, on your KFI in Section 8, you can only actually show your client your rolled-up interest. And sometimes it is difficult to actually sort of to explain to the client what the cost to their estate is going to actually be if they do make them overpayments. So if you go onto the cost of equity release estimator, put in the term, the estimated term that you're using, and put in what that your client is actually looking to repay every month or every year, you'll be able to get a true cost to their estate rather than showing them the rolled up interest on your KFI. And it just cements that picture of what's going to, what their equity release is going to look like in the future. Another feature that we've got, if we've actually got two products in the market at the moment, or two funders. So we've got our core range, which is funded by a third party, and we've also got our principal range, which is funded by Royal London. Now, the core product, which is funded by a third party, there is other lenders in the market that are funded by the same funder. We've got an added little advantage for your remortgage cases. It's just an additional little bonus, but we Royal London Equity Release have teamed up with Vibrant, the UK's largest property service company. A lot of you will be familiar with Vibrant if you do deal with traditional mortgages. But we're providing a free EPC for your clients, your remortgage clients, at completion. As I say, it's just an added little bonus, but it will be particularly nice for your clients who maybe have done home improvements with their equity release funds. So they've got the windows done, got the roof done, and then they get a nice EPC at the end to show how efficient, energy efficient the property is. As I say, that's only on remortgages, but just an added little feature. Right, so just coming on to our flexible approach. This is one of the things that I really want to home in on with Royal London Equity Release. At Royal London, we pride ourselves on a can-do attitude. We don't think about if we can lend on a case. We'll actually think outside the box on how we can lend on the case. We've got a dedicated advisor support team on hand, and they'll provide bespoke services assisting you through the underwriting process, and they will use a common sense approach. So I don't know for you, the ones out there that have used our advisor support team, you can contact them through the BD team at, sorry, BD team at RoyalLondonEquityRelease.com email address, or you can email myself. But basically, they are ex-underwriters with responsible lending, so they do know the criteria inside out. Anyone who has used them will know that they really do delve into your cases. So sometimes it will be a case of subject evaluation, and there's not a lot more we can tell you. But if there is anything else that they need to know at that stage, they will do everything they can to ask you the questions, look at the property, and really try and get underneath the criteria, or what the client's looking to do, to give you as active, as much of a response as they can at the pre-app stage. But as I say, the flexibility side, we are really looking to think outside the box. We have got a strong relationship with the funding partners, and we can obviously get accessibility to chat through with the funders. But because we've now got a new principal plan, which is funded by Royal London, we've also got the added advantage of making in-house decisions. Now, it doesn't mean that we can obviously agree everything, but like I say, we've got a common sense approach. So what I just wanted to do is just that I could tell you lots and lots of various examples, but I'll just give you a few examples of where we've thought outside the box. So we've had a couple of cases recently that have had two kitchens. Normally our criteria is only one kitchen. However, we had one case where two sisters lived together. The property was designed so that they could actually live independently, but it didn't impact future saleability. Now, most lenders had actually declined it because of the two kitchens, but we took a common sense approach on it, and we actually got it through with our lenders, with our funders, sorry. We had another case which was quite similar, which had been declined by other lenders, and the advisor had, it was a gorgeous property, but the client had a swimming pool and had another kitchen, but it was clearly not a real kitchen. Well, it was a kitchen, but it wasn't for the household. It was actually there so that when family came, when children were playing in the pool, they had another kitchen. Nice property to have. Now, a lot of lenders actually deem that as a second kitchen, but again, we took a common sense approach. It was there purely for outside living, for the pool. So again, we got that case through. We've also had a case quite recently. It was about 3 or 4 weeks ago now. Advisor submitted to get the case with one of our funders. The case came in, got declined because there were seven defaults. Our maximum is three defaults. Case got declined, and I went back to the advisor and we had a little chat, got a bit of a story, came back to the funder. Our third party funder, but they still wouldn't accept the case. Now we then looked at that from on our principal plan, which is funded by Roy London, and what we decided was to actually accept the case. Basically, what had happened, it was an ex-school mistress. Her husband had developed dementia, and over the last few years, she'd looked after him at home, and obviously with looking after a dementia. You know, as a carer looking after her husband, her finances, you know, just sort of took second, but basically her finances sort of were in the background, and got into a little bit of a financial mess, got these defaults. But when we got the Experian report, we could clearly see that it wasn't like a serial defaulter. It was just sadly through the situation that she was in, and she just basically couldn't cope. When her husband sadly passed away, she then decided to take out equity release. So we took a common sense approach and could see that it was because of the situation she was in. And we actually accepted that case with seven defaults. We've also had another one, Blacker Four Flats, no management company. Other lenders wouldn't consider it. We asked more questions, asked for a copy of the lease. The lease confirmed that who was responsible for what and at what costs would be split. And we were happy again to take that into account, and we got that one accepted. So there's quite a number of cases. I don't want to, I'm just conscious of time, so I don't want to go through too many. I'll just add one more because it's quite a really good one again. It was a man who was in his 30s, had learning difficulties with no mental capacity and no sign, unable to sign an occupancy waiver. They were paid by the council, but the applicants were paid by the council to look after him. Criteria is that the care, the carer must have an exit plan. And you know, when the applicant passes away, there had to be an exit plan. The applicant didn't want to go back to the council and ask for a care plan to be written up, and other lenders were insistent upon this. They actually had a contract in place with the council, so they sent us this, and we reviewed it, and we were actually happy to go ahead on that basis rather than the client having to then develop an exit plan. So again, just a little bit of an idea, or a flavour, if you like, of our flexibility. So if you do have any cases that are outside criteria, I think the main thing is speak to our broker support or myself. And also it's that story, it's that justification as to why you think we should, you know, look at the case. That's the main thing, things that we will look at. Just coming on to our service. So I don't know how many of you are familiar with the Smart Money People survey, but they're an impartial company and they contact 5,000 brokers every single year. They could be mortgage brokers, commercial brokers, equity release brokers. Now, bearing in mind, we only came into the market last year, in 2023. We actually came second place in the Lifetime Mortgage League, which we are obviously very proud of. We also came first for ease of determining product eligibility, just going back to our criteria that I mentioned before, and satisfaction with relationship managers. And we also scored 80% on all the other metrics, excelling in lender communication, speed of processing, and application through to offer. So I want to highlight this. Now, yesterday, it was also another survey result that we got. It's literally just come in, and we got an interim snapshot of what was on there. But one of the comments was, over and above the team I deal with at Roy London are head and shoulders above their contemporaries in the wider industry. So, for example, in terms of the Rothesay funded product, that's our third party funder, if I'm faced with a choice of identical products with Roy London and other lenders, it will be Roy London that I would recommend, despite the fact that I am with another sourcing system that offers a higher procuration fee. So it just highlights that, you know, we are, because Roy London have got such a good reputation with their pension and wealth and investments, we want to ensure that we're also in line with them and offering the best support and the best service to yourselves. So just wanted to highlight that added little interim that we've got. Right, so just moving on to helping you grow through the value easily. First of all, we're continuing to develop advisor material and sales support, so that you can bring your advice and services to your clients, as well as industry professionals such as wealth managers and IFAs. So what I mean by that is, obviously, we've got a big machine behind us now of Roy London. So we are looking, we are actually just in the process of developing a new hub. And what this is going to have is different presentations on it, so that you can then go to your clients with a presentation. So, for example, if you want to speak to wealth managers, or if you want to speak to estate agents, wherever your introducers are going to come from, we'll have a presentation that you can go out to them and, you know, basically present. Also, our field BDMs, if you do ever need to do a presentation to an audience, then we have got field BDMs who will help you, and they're more than happy to come out and do the actual presentations for you. We've also got some innovative tools will enable you to manage. Sorry, I'm reading off two things here, but they will be able to manage your client relationships and cases efficiently. What we're looking to do, we're actually in the process of building a new broker portal. So in quarter one, 2025, we will have a new broker portal. And we're also continuing to develop and shape our products. And there's a lot of exciting things that are going to be coming in 2025 with our products. We're actively talking to Roy London. In fact, this week we did have Alan Ritchie. His title is a bit of a mouthful, but he's Solutions Design and Experience Development Director. Now, he came to one of our meetings and just reiterated that property is key. Roy London could clearly see the gap in the market when they're talking to their pension and wealth clients. So they know equity lease is you know, a growing market and something that they wanted to be in. And he did clarify that marketing will be a support and not a gimmick. So we are looking forward to see what else that they're going to be doing for ourselves. But also, like I've just briefly mentioned, the business development team, they have got a wealth of knowledge around building professional connections. So as I said, they'll be more than happy to come out to do presentations. But I think once we've got this hub in place, there'll be added support as well. That is pretty much it, Daniel, if you want to come off there.
Fabulous. Yeah, no problem at all. We'll leave you up on screen so people can read through the bits and bobs on screen. But no, that's great presentation. Some of the notes I've taken down, and just to rattle through, just to make sure everybody's also taken some of these notes as well. I think having the ability, and it's very unique to be able to get a KFI back from original research. So having a decline elsewhere and then being able to refer back, so long as it's within 21 days, is incredibly strong. Certainly in today's market. I don't know if anybody's keeping on taps of the current gilt fluctuations and rate movements amongst our lenders. We are currently on a rising market, unfortunately. So that feature in itself is going to be incredibly important over the next couple of weeks. And I hope you're able to get some great client outcomes over the next few weeks within that 21-day period. The EPC, I think that's amazing. Having the ability to allow a client to get the EPC at the end of it with Vibrant for free. Perhaps future innovation, I'll drop this one here, is maybe you'll be able to price more beneficially at the front end if people have a certain EPC. So benefiting clients for looking after their properties at the front end. That would be really cool. And then from an underwriter's perspective, working for a lender myself, you know, I know how incredibly important a part they play in the process, and having, you know, an engaged underwriting team that understand the products and the customer journey throughout, they're able to make risk-based decisions. So on the principal product, that's amazing that you've got that ability in-house with the Royal London funding. And then a good example I used to come across a lot is lots of lenders still decline a case for multiple reasons, but only give you one reason on the decline email. And then frustratingly, you end up resubbing it elsewhere. And it might have been declined for flat roof, but then you sub it elsewhere and something else crops up. So having, again, switched on underwriters, experienced underwriters, know how helpful that additional information can be. And I know from an advisor's standpoint, you know, you can often feel like you're giving too much information, but I'd always encourage advisors to be picking up the phone and speaking and having a trusted conversation to help understand how we can get to a good client outcome. And then the last one, the presentation support. I didn't realize you were offering the BDMs to go out and do presentations for brokers for their introductions. I think that's great tool as well.
If there's a big audience, then they're more than happy to do it, and just support the advisors, really.
Absolutely, absolutely. So now's the time, chat, and everybody that's joined onto the call today, to ask some questions. So we have got one in the inbox, and I'll just ask a quick question first myself by a way of a virtual show of hands. So if you can all have the chat box open, if you can type yes into the chat box over these two questions for me, please, that'll be really good. I'm trying to get you engaged on this call. But so first of all, type yes if you're registered with Royal London already. If you have an advisor registration, so you can write business, request KFIs, engage with the team. So type yes and enter. Bit brilliant. If you're not, I'm going to ask Janet in just a short while to go through the process to actually getting you registered, because I think that's incredibly important. If you're not registered with all the lenders, it's going to be difficult when you come to have a case and you're on the back foot straight away. Second one would be if you can type and engage in the chat box if you've already either recommended, run a quote, or had or done some research where Royal London have been there or thereabouts. So again, pop in yes in the chat box for me if you've recommended a Royal London plan or done any KFIs for them over the, I guess, the last year or since they've been live. That will be really helpful as well, just to understand the volumes of engagement. Just started a query, loads of yeses in there. We have got a no in there as well. So hopefully we
Wonderful.
can get the products to the top of sourcing and have that turn into a yes. There is a question here from Suzanne. Suzanne, thank you for your question here. So are you working with Mortgage Networks to get on panel with them? I don't think Royal London Equity Release is currently on the Primis panel.
We're on. I would say we're probably on 90% of the networks. There is a couple of networks that are just taking a little bit longer, Primus being one of them. I think the other one is St James Place. So they're probably the couple of networks that have come top of my head that aren't registered. It's just a case of, I think they've just got like quite a long, lengthy legal process to actually get to the stage where they can sign. But we are actively, we've got a business development manager, Lisa Windley, who is actively working with the networks. As I say, majority are actually on board, but Primus, unfortunately, is one that isn't. As soon as they are, then all the Primus advisors, all the ARs, registered individuals will be fully communicated with.
Fabulous. And then another question here. And although these are a competitor to us, it's not a problem, Samantha. I don't mind asking it. Are you on the Air Elite? I didn't realise Air Elite was a panel. I know Air Select's a panel, but you should be on Air.
So to get a KFI, you can either get so it, yeah so it, to get a KFI, you can either go on to AdviceWise and any of the other sourcing systems, so Air and Iris. You can get a KFI from all of them. So we're on all the, because I believe Air are polar market now, aren't they? So we are on that panel as well.
Yeah, everything apart from the select panel that they run is whole of market. Just moving on then, if there's no more questions in the chat box, Janet, would you mind explaining how advisors can register with you?
Sorry, just a little bit of cough then. I've actually just put the link on there into the chat. So it's literally a link. And basically all you do, it's an electronic registration, dependent on whether you're an AR or whether you're a directly authorised, or you're a member of a network. There's two separate registrations. It literally takes 2 minutes to do. It's just very basic information. If you're a directly authorised, we'll obviously ask for bank details. If you're a member of a network, we'll just ask for the network. If you're an AR, it's basically name, address, FCA number, and again, bank details. So it literally takes two minutes to do. It's got an electronic signature, comes through to ourselves. We've got an administration team that will register you, and then we'll just send out your logins for our portal, our broker portal.
Fabulous. Okay, brilliant.
We'll also then, once you are registered, what we will do, it's normally myself actually will contact you and just see whether you want a meeting basically with one of the BDMs. So whether you want a face-to-face meeting or whether you want a Teams meeting, just to learn a little bit more in detail about our actual products, which I've not gone into great detail specifically about the products today. There's more about the USPs, but we can do a more in-depth face-to-face or a Teams meeting with you.
Fabulous. No, I naturally have a bias towards the value that BDMs bring to the relationships between advisors and lenders, because they're often the conduit of communication and the solutions focused individuals that are trying to bring both parties together. Is it worth just highlighting your, I guess, regional coverage from a telephone and on a field perspective, just for those advisors on the call that are sat there thinking, well, I'm in South Wales, or I'm in Central London, or I'm in the North, you know, who personally is it that they will have to lean on?
Yeah, okay. So for the north, we've got Lindsay Hudson. So she covers the north of England and also Scotland. We've then got Incan Franklin. Incan has been a BDM in the past with other lenders. So you may know her as Incan Bushnell, but she's recently been married, so she's Incan Franklin. She covers the south and southeast. Sorry, the southeast re really. And then we've got Lisa Windley and myself who cover the Southeast. So a lot of the brokers that I deal with Teams, obviously I'm office based, I'll cover anything over on Teams. But then Lisa will work with the bigger relationships, the bigger networks, and also she's got like a development role as well, sort of away from the BDM. The
Fabulous.
BDM role that she's got. But myself and Lisa basically share the Southeast at the moment.
Fabulous. And then there's another contact or an opportunity there for you. Can you contact Sam regarding some registration of advisors? I'm sure you absolutely can do so.
Yes.
Sam will share your contact details afterwards with Janet, so we can pick up that separately. Not a problem at all. Are there any questions more from the chat? So I have got some questions as well, but I want this to be an opportunity for delegates on the call, advisors to ask any questions. So it could be anything from the features and benefits, the USPs, criteria. You might have a case on your desk right now that you want to take advantage of this time and to ask that question. Just whilst I give you a couple of seconds to put anything in the chat box and type away, I've got one for you, Janet. So I understand it's not possible to generate KFIs through your portal directly. So just in and around that, what's the process there and why is that?
Okay. So at the moment, our broker portal, that there is an illustration tab on there, but it's under construction. The reason it's under construction is obviously coming into the market, our IT has been working really on the integration to get into the source and systems. So that has been the priority to be integrated with all the source and systems. Now we are working on a broker portal and a brand new broker portal. Excuse me. So currently, if you do need a KFI, you can't get it off the broker portal. You have to go to your source and system to get it. So, for example, AdviceWise, go onto your sourcing with AdviceWise and produce the KFI that way. If for whatever reason you can't get a KFI off your source and system, maybe for example, you know the product's there, but you just can't see it for whatever reason, it's just not showing, maybe it's not being filtered correctly, then you can give us a call and you can also email us. And we'll always do the illustration for you as well. So basically what happens, you get your KFI from your sourcing. Within 24 hours, that will appear on the broker portal, and then you can submit your application, if that makes sense. So although the illustration tab is on the portal, please don't use it at the moment. But quarter one, 2025 is when we're anticipating having a new broker portal where you can get them in the future.
Great stuff. And then a tying a little bit more in detail on that, and presume with when somebody's had a decline and they want to take advantage of the 21 days, refer back to my old piece of research, often rates will have moved. So live sourcing systems like our own, you won't be able to request KFIs for that. I presume that's a get in contact with you and there'll be a manual process.
Get in touch with myself. And then we've got our IT team that will actually build the KFI for you.
Fabulous. Okay, so we've got solutions all round, which is
Yes.
great to hear. This is great to hear. Is there any more questions from the room? Because if there isn't, I think we'll start to round up. But if there's any questions from the room, but again, please do take advantage of the chat box. If there isn't, I'll start to put what I'm putting in the chat box right now is just a list of any future events that are new and noteworthy. So we at AdviceWise obviously host quite a few events just like this. We host lenders all the time. There are quite a number of noteworthy live events coming up as well. So in a couple of days' time, LV are doing a live in London event. So you can visit our events calendar, which I've linked to find out what that is. Financial Report are doing the Mortgage and Protection Summit on the 13th of November. For any equity release specialists, hopefully you're well aware that the Equity Release Council will be doing their previously named Equity Release Summit, but it's going to be the Later Life branded summit now. And that's on the 19th of November in Cutlass Hall, I believe it's Sheffield. So hopefully we'll be able to see you all there. It's got a jam-packed agenda, which they're circulating at the moment. And I know it costs to go. It's significantly cheaper than the one earlier in the year. It's about 30 odd quid, I believe. So hopefully see you there. And then there's a couple more to note there as well. But on the same theme, if you're ever looking for CPD similar to this or any other webinars or any live events, please take advantage of our events calendar. We try and host and advertise as many as possible on there. Most of them, if not all of them, are free to attend in some way, shape or form. So certainly a great way to get your CPD. I've not seen any other questions come in. Please do shout up if I've missed any throughout all the yeses in the chat box. But I'd just like to take an opportunity to thank Janet for your time this morning. Thank you guys, all delegates, for joining us on a Wednesday morning as well. I know it's still quite early and we're probably only one coffee in. Again, to reiterate, this session is or has been recorded. So what that essentially means is you will be able to watch it back retrospectively. We will send a link to the video so that you can watch that back, share it with your peers, and you will get a link to request your CPD certificates as well. So, if you haven't already engaged with AdviseWise as a sourcing platform, it's free to register. Please do. If you'd like a demo, we've innovated so much over the last year to 6 months. We've put some real good calculators and tools on the platform as well. If you'd like to run through a demo through them with us personally, you're more than welcome to do so as well. But that's all from us. Any more from yourself, Janet?
No, I can't think of anything. But yeah, I think the main thing is just to encourage people to register if they're not registered. And also, if they've got a case and they need to talk it through, just get in touch. That's the main thing.
Great stuff. Thanks, everybody. Yeah. So I'll hang around with yourself, Janet, and we'll just let everybody leave. But free to leave. Have a great rest of the day. Have a great rest of the week. And we hope to see you all on the next one.